Very often in life, we're taught simple things which are really just cover stories for a more complex truth. For example, as children, we're taught that there are 24 hours in each day. But this is just one such cover story, albeit a very useful and effective one. But it simplifies a more complex and, frankly, much, much more interesting truth. My name is Richard, I'm a watchmaker, and if you are new to my channel, you are very, very welcome. And in this video, we're going to look at the real story behind the cover story. So, let's start with a simple question. Here is the first question. How many degrees does the Earth turn in one 24-hour period, one day? Let's ask Google. And here's the answer. Google quite clearly says that the Earth rotates 360 degrees, that's one revolution, in 24 hours. Now this is not correct. In fact, Google appear to be in on the simplified cover story. Let's imagine you're on the Earth at point X. The sun is directly overhead, so it is midday on day one. The Earth then revolves one complete revolution, 360 degrees, and it is midday on day two. Again, the sun is directly overhead. But this, of course, is a simplification. To see what's actually going on, we have to remember that the Earth is moving around the sun as it spins on its axis. So let's take a look at what really happens in 24 hours. So we start again with the sun directly overhead, and the Earth is spinning on its axis, but this time it is also moving in relation to the sun. At 360 degrees, because of its movement, the sun is not quite overhead. It has to move another degree for the sun to come directly overhead for midday. So in 24 hours, the Earth actually revolves 361 degrees. And this is what a clockmaker or an astronomer would call one solar day. So I guess Google should have said that the Earth turns exactly one revolution in 23 hours and 56 minutes. And we have a name for this. This is called a sidereal day. And sidereal means to do with the stars. Now we can much more accurately time an exact single rotation of the Earth by observing the stars. This is because the stars are so far away that the movement of the Earth around the Sun has no real effect on the measurement. Okay, so what's the big deal? My watch is just in sync with the Sun, right? Well, actually, no, it isn't. And to demonstrate why, let's take a trip to Norway.
And it is a lovely sunny morning here in the capital of Norway, in Oslo, at the Vigeland Sculpture Park. And we have found a sundial.
But this is weird. What is this stretched out kind of figure of eight thing right on the noon position of this sundial? Okay, so let's come in closer and have a look at this thing. Now you can see that on the left hand side we've got the months of October and November, and on the right hand side we've got January and February, and in the middle there's a compensation scale for minutes. And it's not a small amount of minutes. This is plus or minus 15 minutes, quarter of an hour a day. So what is this thing? Well, if you were to position a camera pointing at the same piece of sky and take a photograph at midday every day, you might expect the sun to appear in the same place, or at least directly overhead. In fact, if you were to plot the location of the sun at that time throughout the year, you would see that it traces out a path not unlike the one that we see on the sundial. Now, this stretched out figure of eight shape is actually called an analemma. And on the sundial, it exists to compensate for the variation in a solar day compared with the time shown on your watch. For the natural rhythm of the sun is not regular, whereas the man-made rhythm on your watch is regular every day. Well, with this military spec Rolex from the 1970s, almost regular. This one is actually really good and is only out by a second or so a day. But compared with the natural rhythm of the sun, it's only accurate 4 days in the year. And the rest of the time, it's somewhere on this path of inaccuracy from a couple of minutes to 15 minutes a day. So to create days of the same length throughout the year, what we did was just take the average, and we call that the mean solar time. And on 4 days a year, this is actually the same as the real solar time. So what mankind has done here is quite clever, really. We've observed the natural rhythms of the solar day and of the sidereal day. We've noted the fact that the solar day changes whilst the sidereal day stays constant, but the solar day is so much closer to home. So we averaged out the natural rhythm of the sun to create a time system which was both accurate and regular. For human collaboration, this is brilliant. But as with all cover stories, there are risks too. A good cover story, and this is a really good one, will have the following characteristics. It will be as close to the truth as possible. It should be really, really useful, and people should just want to believe it. But in creating this cover story and being what is at the end of the day unfaithful to the stars, we have divorced ourselves from the natural rhythms. And with that comes risk. It is 6:43 in the evening in Pembroke Dock. The moon, a full moon, is in the right place, but the man-made clock on the church tower says that it's 10:30 because it stopped.